So there are two types of lazy eyes, and one type of lazy eye is called amblyopia. By definition, amblyopia is when the eye cannot see clearly, even despite given the best glasses or contact lens prescription. So we believe amblyopia is because it has to do with the pathway from that eye to the brain, and it's not sending strong enough signals as the eye that sees clearly. So I'm going to talk to you about six ways about how to help fix amblyopia. Number one, get the right prescription. So a lot of times when we see patients with amblyopia, it's because they have an unequal prescription between the two eyes and they have never worn glasses. So what happens in that case is that the eye that has no prescription sees really clearly, and then the brain just kind of ignores or forgets about the other eye. It happens a lot, especially in farsighted prescriptions. So tip number one is to make sure that you're getting the right prescription and you're wearing it all the time. Because if you're not wearing glasses or contacts and getting the right prescription on each eye, you're not giving the eye the full potential to be able to see clearly. Number two is switch to contact lenses. So when you have an unequal glasses prescription, it causes this condition called anisometropia. Anisometropia is a difference in power of the two lenses. When you have a different prescription in each side of your glasses, it can cause this phenomenon called anisokonia, which means a different image size. The size of the image that the eye sees through the higher prescription will be larger than the image size that you see through the other sides of the glasses. Now your brain's trying to put that together, but if one image is bigger than the other image, it doesn't exactly line up. That can also be a deterrent to fixing amblyopia. So if you switch to contact lenses actually make the image size more similar between each eye and hence can help fix the amblyopia better. They also have special glasses that can help to equalize the image size as well if for some reason the patient isn't able to wear contact lenses. Tip number three is try something called a blur contact. So in amblyopia, we see that one eye sees clear and the other eye sees blurry. We know that in amblyopia, it's a rivalry issue. The two eyes don't work together because they're not seeing equally. So if you want to encourage the eyes to see more equally and to work together, why don't you make the eye that sees too clearly a little bit less clear? We call that a blur contact. By doing that, at least the eyes are more equal so that the weaker eye, the eye with amblyopia, can start to participate better. By doing that, by getting that eye engaged, you're gonna make that eye stronger and it's eventually gonna see clearer. You don't have to be wearing this blur contact forever, but think of it as part of your training process. Tip number four, my favorite, is what can really help with amblyopia is something called vision therapy. Vision therapy are exercises for the eyes and the brain to help train vision. Vision therapy is very effective to treat amblyopia, and it's a whole lot more fun than some of the old school treatments like wearing a black pirate patch over your eye. No fun at all. Vision therapy uses activities, exercises, fun technology like a virtual reality headset or computer games or different kind of puzzles that you're going to be doing, and all of these activities are aimed around strengthening the vision of the weaker eye. Now, if you don't have an office near you that does vision therapy, there are at-home vision therapy computer programs that have been designed as well. In my personal opinion, I know it's not as great as having a weekly coach that's going to help you and encourage you and teach you the right way to use your vision. But in some cases, that's all that might be available. And I still think that's better than not doing anything at all. So these computer programs, a lot of times, will have you put on special glasses and they'll have you play games like shooter games or puzzles or Tetris. And all of these games are working on what we call anti-suppression, meaning you don't want to favor the eye that sees clearer and forget about the amblyopic eye. You want to use both eyes at the same time, trying to make them as equal as possible. That's the whole purpose of these at-home computer games for lazy eyes. So if you are motivated to play them and you practice them daily, you actually will see improvement, because anything that you're doing to engage that eye and to get it to work together with the other eye is a great thing. Lastly, If you don't have access to any of these things, there at least is something called a translucent patch that you can wear. In patching, the concept is that you're going to cover the eye that sees stronger to make the eye that sees weaker practice doing the work. So you can keep this patch on when you're eating dinner, when you're watching TV, when you're doing homework. If the patient sees so blurry out of the amblyopic eye, it can be kind of frustrating at the beginning because they're having to go through their world looking only through the blurry side. But over time, the hope is that it feels more comfortable and they get more used to it, and then the vision will improve. One huge tip I have if you are going to do patching for amblyopia is please at least use a patch that has light coming through it, not the black pirate patch. Because the black pirate patch will take the other eye completely out of the picture. But we understand amblyopia. The goal of treating amblyopia is to get the eyes to work together. So at least if you have a patch that's like a little bit see-through, let some light in, it's not completely clear, but it's just like a little bit foggy, that will ultimately let both eyes work better together. So those are my 6 tips for helping to treat amblyopia. Like I said, it is very successful to treat and it can be done, and it doesn't matter the age. You're never too old to try, even if you're an adult. We have seen adults get better vision when they start to implement some of these things. So I hope that was helpful, and most of all, I hope your vision gets better. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time.